story time made me believe that, okay, you are interested in knowing more about what happened in my life. And this is one story which I promised you along, like since 2 years I'm promising you this story. But I was very afraid ki janna hoga, nahi janna hoga. But today, here it is. The crux of the story is how my head burst open while going for an adventure ride and how I had to get stitches to get all right. So this whole story is based when I was in 5th standard, which is as good as being 11 years old, and me and my family had gone to this vacation to Mahabaleshwar. It was me, my mum, my dad and my grandmum. It was the four of us. So we were just going to get petrol filled. On our way, we saw this go-karting place. So I mentioned that, okay, I would really like to go there. But my family was like, pehle petrol bhara lete, and then while coming back, if it's on our way, we can consider it. Now, another thing that is to be noted is that at that point of time, I had never cut my hair in my entire life. So this is one thing in my religion that we follow, that we women do not get to cut our hair with any sharp objects. And back then, fire cutting bhi allowed nahi tha. Baal nahi, matlab kaatne hi nahi hai. Kaise bhi nahi hai. So I had hair which was as long as till my knees. So I had a plait bandhi thi, a braid. So that braid was also very long, like it came just above my knee. And every time we went to a theme park, like say SL World or any theme park, we would always tie a braid and then we would fold it. So if this is my braid, then we'd fold it once, twice and thrice to make sure that my hair is not hanging loose to get caught into anything. But because this go-karting thing was not planned, we did not have that hairstyle on me at that time. My braid was pretty long, like longer than this as well. So while coming back, the go-karting place was still on our way, and we decided to go. So mom and I were going to be in one go-kart and dad and my grandmom in another. So first, because I was this overly hyped, excited kid, I decided ki main aur mummy pehle hi jayenge. And I wanted to drive the go-kart. It was a professional car jaisa tha, like an F1 car, you know, how that looks and how the whole thing works. Plus, the most dangerous thing I felt about that place at that time was it was at an elevated land because it is a hill station. Course ka jo edge tha na, that was a valley. Agar wo edge ke through humne drive kar diya hota, instead of taking a turn, we would be in the valley directly. So to prevent that from happening, they had placed two tires at the end. And even as a kid, I thought ki yaar ye do tire kitna protect karenge agar suppose full speed mein steering fail ho gaya, to bhi hum seedha gir jate valley ke andar. But still, being a kid, I'm taking life for granted ki haan kuch nahi hoga. And we sat in the go-kart. It was two rounds. So one round was mom's and the second round would be me. So the moment my mom pressed the accelerator, I screamed, and it was a very, very loud, shrill scream. And for me, I don't remember anything from that point till the time I woke up in my car, blood all over me. So then after I woke up, after my whole surgery happened, then I got to know about the true story. I screamed, there was blood oozing out of my head. People gathered, we realized that my braid was stuck in the engine of the go-kart, and the engine was moving at such a speed where it pulled the hair out. There was a huge opening in my head and it was just oozing blood out like anything. Because it was the head, people were worried that it could result in memory loss or any internal brain or head injury. So they were not letting me fall asleep. So after I woke up in the car, when they were rushing me to the hospital, they kept asking me questions like, do you know your first cousin's name? Do you know who we are? What is our name? What is your name? So they were just checking that my memory loss has not happened. At the scene, what happened, which I found out later, was once people gathered, they were like haldi lagata iske wound ke upar to stop the blood flow. But my dadi, being the smart woman that she is, she told them no, because aajkal ka haldi mein bahut chemicals hota hai, so that could result in a very high infection. So they just took a rumal and they had like put it on, it was exactly here, so they put it on my head to help the blood stop from flowing out, and that's how they took me to the hospital. There was this Red Cross hospital. I'll never forget that hospital because it was clean and the whole service is very, very nice. Like, I still remember it vividly. So we went to the Red Cross hospital and there they gave me an anesthesia which only made this part of my head numb, and then they were giving me stitches. So it wasn't painful, but because it was a partial anesthesia and I was still awake when the whole surgery was happening, I could feel the needle going in and coming out. Like, I know this is TMI, but I just thought of sharing every detail that I remember. So I could feel ki okay, the needle has come out now. But it wasn't that painful. And then after the whole stitches happened, when we asked them how much do we owe them, they're like, we can't charge you for this because we're a charity hospital. Father later on did remit them. We left directly for home because it was such a severe injury. I needed to be kept under proper care. And bahar gaon mein kabhi utna care nahi ho sakta jitna apne khud ke ghar pe hota. So jaise hi surgery ho gaya na, we left to go back home. And when the anesthesia wore off, the amount of internal head pain I felt was crazy. It was paining like anything. I was just crying all the whole way back that it's paining. And they gave me sleep medicine and painkillers so that, you know, I can be at rest. And then we went, we stopped at the local McDonald's. So usually I had to, you know, really persuade them ki chalo na McD mein khate as a kid. But at that time, wo log samne se leke gaye to, you know, make me feel as emotionally better as they can. Ki, let's stop at a McDonald's. They got me a very cool swimming wala video game. There was a time when McDonald's used to give video games as Happy Meals, okay? And I missed that time because I would still buy a Happy Meal if they would give a video game. So I got this cool video game which kept me distracted for a while. And then once we reached home, I would regularly have to keep changing my dressing. Then school resumed. This happened during the vacation, but I did not heal even when the school resumed. So I had to go to school also like that. And the only annoying part about that was that because my friends and teachers cared so much, everybody would ask me what happened. So I had to narrate this very story 100 times. If only I would make YouTube videos back then, I would just tell them, please video dekh lo, I can't repeat the whole thing again. Once the stitches were to be opened, they just cut it without any anesthesia because wo heal barabar se ho gaya tha. And then when they were taking that stitch out, I could feel that it was painful, but I did heal properly. I still have a scar in my head. I will never have hair grow in that patch, but it's a small scar. So mujhe aisa, you know, I don't feel like I have a bald patch up here. So the moral of the story is do not go into random adventure places because it isn't safe. Now the biggest mistake was mine, that I did not tie my hair up because I'm responsible for my own life. Then the other little problem I had from their end was I asked for a helmet and they said they don't have a helmet. And there was a pile of helmets in front of me. So I'm like, udhar to hai, but they're like, nahin, nahin, wo use nahin kar sakte. So that was a drawback ki, okay, they didn't give me any safety gear. Except the hand gloves for the steering wheel. So, but we still went, so that is our mistake again. We should not have gone on the go-kart if they're not giving us safety measures, but we did. So please learn from my incident. Do not go to these random adventure parks unless there is proper safety measures. And if you have long hair, please tie it before you go on any rides. The weird part was, because I was a kid, I would take it very lightly. Like there was my favorite t-shirt, this blue t-shirt. So when the whole surgery happened, I was telling my mom that mummy, my favorite t-shirt kharab ho gaya khoon ki wajah se. And my mom was like, are you mad? You care about a blooming t-shirt when your head is torn apart? That was a very like innocent comment on my part. So after my stitches had also opened up, my family was just like, okay, safety is important over religion. And they, from this length of hair, like even longer than this, they got me itne chote baal. So this was a scissor cut. This has been the only scissor cut of my life till date. So they got me the shortest haircut possible that I would agree to, just to make sure that they won't grow out long for a long, long time. But after that, they spoke to a few authoritarian figures when it comes to my religion. And they did tell them that we need some way to cut our hair. So they were like, okay, don't use any sharp objects, no blades, no knives, no scissors. But you can try fire cutting. So fire cutting is when you burn your hair, but in a specific way where you can get the style you want. So there is one trained professional in my city whom I always go to cut my hair. It's very expensive, which is I have not cut my hair in 2 years because I don't want to spend that kind of money and I'm enjoying long hair right now. But since that day, I've gotten fire cuts only. I'm glad that my family did make religious adjustments when this happened. And I still remember the first time when I got super short hair, because when I had short hair, I was a baby. So when I got my scissor cut and my hair was this short, I would just keep doing this. Like I had never known how it it feels to have short hair. So now not only me but all the women in at least my family, I can't speak for all the Veds in my religion, but all the women in my family do get a fire haircut. And the next time I go for a fire haircut, I'll take you along with me too. I have been 2 times in the past 3 years and I've vlogged both those times. If you want to watch the whole vlog in detail, I'll leave the links down below. I hope you enjoyed watching the story time, but more than the enjoyment, learned something from it, and I'll see you in the next video. Until then, goodbye.